Hey guys, today I've got 10 summer colognes you could buy for under $39. The first one's going to be called Dolce & Gabbana Discover Volcano. Came out in 2014. It's a little bit of a more advanced version of Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue. And by advanced, I mean it's not your typical ocean fresh aquatic. It is ocean fresh aquatic, but it's got more depth to it with the notes of green herbal notes like cypress and things like that. And if you wanted to compare this with this one here called Bleu de Chanel, they go very much in the same direction. This is the Parfum edition. They both share the same top notes. The difference is this Bleu de Chanel has a sandalwood note, making it a little bit more fresher, and this one uses more green herbal notes like vetivers and cypresses and things like that. Outstanding longevity, blind buy worthy, about on the ticker of 5 of 1 to 10, but very good for office wear, very good for scent sillage and longevity. It's a cool little hidden gem. We start today's summer fragrance out like that because my nephew, he tells me what music to buy because he's only 21 years old. And then he says, hey, Uncle Chris, show me some cheap fragrances. I'm sick of these $80, $100 fragrances you keep putting on your dresser and you only let me spray them twice on Sunday. Can you show me some more? I said, sure. So number 9 on the list is going to be called Perry Ellis Red 360. Instantly in 1 hour, you will get a compliment with this fragrance. Just spray it like that, like 6-7 times all over yourself. And it smells like Acqua di Gio, an old classic. That's $20. For this and the old classics like $100. Here's a very cool fragrance, and I bought this out, Versace Mano Fresh, but this isn't the one I'm talking about. Hey, does anybody know about this? I don't see it being talked about anymore because I think someone told me in 2020 or the new formulations suck. Is that true? This thing beats it out all day long. I even did a survey about Versace Pour Homme, that's what it's called. Also known as Versace Pour Homme Signature. Okay, we'll get that straight. This thing lasts 8 hours. It's a fresh, lemony, citrusy, fresh scent with florals. It's delicious, and everybody in fragrance community respects this fragrance, even though it's way older than this one. Next fragrance on the list is a Dumb Reach Dumb Blanc. Just a simple fragrance you can always go good with. Nautica Voyage. You can wear this to the gym, to the office, in the hot summer heat, whatever you want. It's a plain and simple, freshy aquatic for beginner fragrance users. Now we want to put something a little bit different. And I thought about some Guerlain stuff, but I couldn't get it under $39. But this one, if you search good enough, you can find it. It's called Givenchy Pie, a beautiful vanilla leather fragrance with depth, perfect for your date nights or just an upscale night or when you're dressed up a little bit bored. You can put this in any situation as well, and it has this lock on it, and they did make this in older times. It was much stronger with a different sort of pie on it. If you ever define one with a small little pie sign on it, you'll have yourself a gem, my friend. Oh yeah, leather, vanilla, sweet, went right in my nose. The next fragrance I love to wear in the summer is called Costa Azura Aqua by Tom Ford. Unfortunately, this thing is $300. It's too bad. It's a very minimalistic, delicious fragrance. But you could get, and it goes in the same minimalistic way, Chrome Aqua. The difference is that, of course, the main difference, Tom Ford uses myrtle, which is a herbal note, a green shrub, so to speak, which can produce a sage or incense aroma coming from this, depending on how it's combined with the other ingredients in it. Chrome Aqua has basil, mint, aquatic, and one viewer called Chrome Aqua Bleu de Chanel Sport Edition to give you that idea. Next fragrance is pretty good. It's actually called Coach Platinum. It's a silver bottle. You can use this in all year round temperature, and you can go to work with it, and it has a pineapple opening. And when it dries down, people compare this to a mature version, very creamy version of Versace Eros. Are you familiar with that? And the thing about this particular fragrance called Coach Platinum is that ladies love it. I've even been in department stores and guys were looking at Versace's and stuff, and I heard random women as he's talking to the salesperson and she was showing him this. This was back a couple years ago, and the girls walking by said, dude, that is an A-lister, you need to get it. Of course, it was a brand new release and Coach, and they've never seen it. So that plus that could equal an endorphin rush, but it did garner lots of compliments. And to this day, I get lots of emails that say Coach Platinum for $39 or less gets me lots of compliments. This is probably one of the most complimented fragrances on this list. Next fragrance we're gonna talk about is Invictus Aqua for the summer, but unfortunately you can't find it for $39 or less. but you can find Mont Blanc Legend Spirit. This is a delicious fragrance with bergamot and aquatics, and it gets you compliments. And I can wear this to the gym, and I can spray it 3 or 4 times to the gym all over my shirt, or I can wear it like this, going to church, doing whatever activity you want. It's totally 100% 10 out of 10 versatile, and it does have a nice performance to it, like 4 to 6 hours. And if you spray like me, you'll get up in that 6 hour note. And here's the new one that smells like Invictus Aqua, Abercrombie Fitch Authentic Blue. This one here is $29.99. It's a delicious green apple starting off fragrance that's a little bit different than this one, but gives you that same chrome aqua effect. It's very, very decent for the price, and you will get lots of compliments. It's very fun to wear, and like when you spray it, you instantly smile. Now, one of my favorite fragrances on the list is called Versace Eros Flame. This fragrance has lemons and mandarin, and gives you this orange Italian soda vibe at first, but when it finally dries down, it dries down to a similar scent to regular Versace Eros. But in the beginning, you've got the strong citrus, and you have a nice vanilla undertone, which I absolutely adore. The longevity on Eros is incredible. The projection is way above average. Compliments are good if you wear it correctly. This one you might have to consider and test out the number of sprays, because it can get kind of fresh, but right off the bat, it's blasting my nose, but my nose is used to that, so maybe you might not be used to it if you're beginning with fragrances. But this is definitely one, if you're new to fragrances, I would only suggest you spray it twice at first, because it can be super strong blast of lemon pepper at first. But after you wait to dry it down, it's a nice, nice summer fragrance. Hey, since you waited all this time to watch the end of the video, why don't I give you 3 bonuses? Fragrances that smell like other fragrances. Let's demensify these snobby fragrances. Number one, if you like Versace Man Fresh, if you like Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue, $50, $40, $50, $60, $70 fragrance, just simply get this for the summer. Antonio Banderas Blue Seduction. And he's friends with Dolce & Gabbana, and the old story goes that they gave him the Light Blue before they approved Light Blue. And he made this fragrance called Seduction Blue. The next fragrance, if you want to smell like Paco Rabanne Invictus for $20, find yourself this, Whatever It Takes by Mr. Kanye West. It's a cool fragrance. Whatever It Takes, he put his art on it. Not sure if he's actually Kanye West fragrance, but it does have a nice aquatic fragrance that does last anywhere from 5 to 7 hours for $20. You can't beat that. It's kind of hard to find. It's getting less and less to find. And if you want to smell like Creed, Green Irish Tweed on a Buzzard, find this one, Aramaf Trey Nui. If you have any experience with any of these fragrances, comment down below. YouTube suggests you to watch this video next. Say hello to my nieces and nephews and aunts and uncles. Peace and love. I'll see you on the next video.